First up to speak to you today is President Widing from Stockholm University. Please welcome President Widing.
Good morning, everybody. As president of Stockholm University, I'm extremely proud and happy today to be hosting for the first time this unique Molecular Frontier Symposium, Planet Earth, a Scientific Journey. And I would like to take this opportunity, first of all, to thank the Molecular Frontiers Foundation for inviting us to co-arrange and be part of this fantastic reoccurring event. Earth is the only place in the universe that we know harbors life. Life that might have started with some molecules for about 3.8 billion years ago. Every year, thousands of new plants and animal species are found. And during the history of the Earth, species have come and gone, and changes and disasters have provided new opportunities for new life forms to have a chance to establish themselves. But never have the changes gone so fast in the Earth's long history as they do now. Climate change is something we all notice and which will change the conditions for, above all, future generations. But looking out over Aula Magna today and seeing all of you, young people, sitting here, indeed gives me hope. During these 2 days to come, we will be listening to lectures on the Earth, its history and challenges. We will mingle together, award prizes, and share ideas and thoughts. I firmly believe in dialogue and shared experience, and I think that the fact that you young people here now have the opportunity to meet and talk with perhaps not always so young, but very experienced researchers in science, including several Nobel laureates, that this is a wonderful thing and a way to find inspiration for the future, to search for new opportunities and solutions. So it is my great pleasure to wish you all warmly welcome to Stockholm University for the 2 days to come, hoping that they will be both exciting and rewarding. Enjoy.
On behalf of the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences, it is my pleasure as the president of the Academy to welcome you to this symposium. This year is a very special year for chemistry and molecules. We are celebrating the 150th anniversary of the periodic table presented by Dmitri Mendeleev in 1869. This will surely put chemistry in the limelight, which is of course very much needed because there are so many misconceptions about chemistry in society. For myself, as a neuroscientist, pharmacologist, and evolutionary biologist, everything I do in my research builds directly on the foundations provided by chemistry. This year's theme for the Molecular Frontier Symposium is highly topical. I very much look forward to the presentations with very exciting titles. Let me also, if I may, take this opportunity to announce that the Academy of Sciences is organizing a symposium on plastic pollution in the oceans and what we can do about it. This will take place on June 13th and 14th, and this is organized in collaboration with the IUCN, the International Union for Conservation of Nature. So please check the Academy of Sciences website for further information of that. I very much look forward to this symposium, and with that, I hand the word over to Stefan Bengtsson, the President and Chief Executive Officer of Chalmers University of Technology. I wish you all a rewarding symposium. Thank you.
Thank you, and good morning, everyone. Chalmers University of Technology is supporting Molecular Frontiers, and I've been co-organized a number of symposia over the years. We're very happy now to be able to hold this symposia at Stockholm University around planet Earth. We are facing challenges, and we need to find ways of having a sustainable life here at Earth for a growing population while preserving the ecodiversity that is necessary. Science is a key in understanding the challenges and problems we are facing, as well as in finding the solutions. And chemical processes are key in most of the things happening at our planet. However, things are very complex, and we need to work across various scientific disciplines. I really look forward myself also to this symposia to learn and to discuss what opportunities there are. It's also fantastic to see all you young persons being here. You are the future, and you are the ones that will need to find the way forwards here. And we have great opportunities, and I would like to say the same way as Professor Widing. It gives me hope seeing you here. So today we will talk about planet Earth. I will already announce that there will be also another symposia this year in Gothenburg about light at the nanoscale in December. So mark that in your schedules. But now it's about planet Earth. Welcome here. I look forward to this symposia, and thank you very much. I will now hand over to the next speaker, the chairman of Molecular Frontiers, Professor Karin Markides. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. It's really nice to see you all here, and I'm very happy to be able to really invite you to these 2 days of working with your curiosity. So molecules, why molecules? We all know that molecules define most everything in this world. That makes it very complex. And it also makes it necessary, like we have for many, many years, divided the disciplines in science into different topics and different disciplines to go deep and to understand from different perspectives, to really be able to go to really be able to handle and develop the possibilities with molecules and what nature has really also developed over all these years with molecules. But what is specific here today with this symposium that is part of the what Molecular Frontiers are giving out to the next generation? It is that this symposium is actually focusing on how scientists with expertise in different disciplines in molecular understanding come together and really look upon a matter of global significance. You can see here on this slide some different topics that have been in focus for this type of a symposia. And it can cover a lot of different aspects because molecules is, of course, everywhere. So here we can see that healthy aging and brain and origin of life and so forth. And today we are focusing on the planet Earth. And I really feel that this is going to be a very nice experience for you. And please open your mind, really try to see how you can identify some questions for these leading scientists that we have here today. And take this opportunity to really talk to them, because this is actually what they also hope for. The best you can do to in appreciation for what you are given here for these 2 days is really to put some questions forward, and all questions are good. So you can see here when these are some pictures here from symposia at other places where we've been in Japan and also in United States, in Hungary and so forth. And we usually have meetings with Molecular Frontiers like this in Sweden now and then. And as you heard, there will be another one this year later. So you can keep up on Molecular Frontiers. They have, of course, a homepage. And there you can also find another unique possibility with Molecular Frontiers. You will also hear more about that this afternoon. And that is that we love questions so much in Molecular Frontiers that we even have a competition on questions. But that will come later today. Now you have, please write down what you think and take this opportunity later on today to ask questions to our leading scientists. We are so happy to have them here, and we are even more happy that you are here. And just enjoy these 2 days. And this is the way that you can actually make a difference, not only for you, because what you see and hear and learn here, but also for these scientists. They really can take with them what you are asking them. Thank you very much. Enjoy. Now, this man here, Bengt Nordén, and he is actually the one that started this whole idea about Molecular Frontiers.
I'll be very brief. I was put into the program to say the things that the previous speakers forgot to say, and there is nothing. But again, warmly welcome, and especially to the young audience. It's so important, your presence here. And I want you, as Karin said, think about questions and file questions, open here or via the internet. And I also want you to interact with the speakers here, who are the top scientists in the world, and interact with each other. We have experience of a very good tradition that young people from different origin, different nations, interact and come together and keep a communication over the years. I think this is very healthy. So now I would like to introduce Laurie Carnot, who you have already seen. You know, a conference like this does not organize itself by itself. It requires a lot of preparations. And we have many people who have been involved in the preparation and planning of this symposium. But Laurie is the one who has put in, I would say, 91.5% of the efforts. And she has, from the beginning, had the dream about what planet Earth would be about, who would be the speakers, and what we are going to interact about. Because the program is very wide. It spreads widely, but not thinly. And this we can thank Laurie for. So I suggest we give Laurie a hand. She will be the chair of the next session. So here she comes.
Thank you, Ben. So I want to thank all who have helped to make this program possible. Our co-presenters, the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences, Chalmers University, and our host, Stockholm University. We are also want to thank our sponsors, Ferring Pharmaceuticals, Shell Mata Biostifle, Swedish Research Council, the Stiftelseverband, Explorers Museum Global Alliance, World Scientific, Molecular Frontiers Journal, Jason Learning, Peregrine Holdings, and Sandvik. Science is a discipline that manages to transcend borders. The important topic of this symposium, planet Earth, also transcends generations. For this, we have enlisted the help of a number of student ambassadors around the world, some of whom you'll be meeting over the next couple days. Many of the participants here also provided entries for our global student competition on solutions for future Earth. And you will see a number of their entries in poster format on display. The winners will be announced at the end of the program today. After this, we're going to have a demonstration of Sandvik's unsmashable guitar, highlighting that what can be imagined, science, engineering, and technology can achieve. And this is followed by a student reception. So any of you that want to stay on and continue our discussions today, you're most welcome. So even though today, the topic for this symposium is of an earthly nature, I think that you will agree that we have assembled a stellar roster of speakers over the next couple days. Together, they provide an especially exciting and synergistic compilation of knowledge, spanning a broad range of disciplines and experience. In order to best address the challenges ahead that the planet and its inhabitants will encounter, it is important to understand what is happening and why. Only then can we navigate the best path forward. Now please sit back, turn off your phones, and enjoy the symposium. Thank you.